This is a video on the structure of such a shoe model. I wanted to create the whole model only with the use of sketches and NURBS methods. So we start first with part design body object with some helper objects. These are some datum planes and some control points here. And inside or on base of these helpers, I create sketches. I hide the helpers. We see this structure of sketches. The sketches should connect in points, but if there is a small distance, I have my methods made so robust that no error will occur. That means later, after sketching process, I can constrain all these things with the helper planes and with expressions. So from these sketches, the next step is to create curves, Bezier curves. We see this model. The yellow curve depends on the sketch. I will demonstrate it later. And now I have already a model of the shoe. And in the next sketch, in the next step, I create faces on top of these curves, and there are still some areas where we do not have tangent constraint, but this is the next step. What we have here are faces which connect together, which fit in the border curves and the yellow curves. Also here we have an idea how we can connect them to the mean value of some endings. And this is now the result. And I want to demonstrate some details. The first detail is how I can create such a face from the curves given here. I select four curves. This is an idea which also is used in the Gordon surface algorithm, and I create here a product of these faces, and so I get this one. This can I do anywhere. Also, it's possible that I create such a surface only by three edges. In this case, there is no influence of this part, so the face is a little bit other. If I need here this arc, I have to define this extra curve and to add it to the model. But in some cases, maybe that we also need only some a little number of curves. For example, if I use two curves, then the result is the sweep of one curve along the other curve. This is a well-known feature in part and part design, a sweep along a path, and there is no difference whether I sweep this curve along this path or this curve along this path. The result is always the same. So this way I have created all these faces, and now I can change the model by changing the sketches. So I open the sketches, and now I can say I want this sketch. This I want to edit it. The problem is when I start the editor, the pending object is hidden. So I want to see the impact of a change in real time. And now I have here the sketch, and here is the depending face. And when I drag it in this direction, the face follows. Okay, And this I can do in any case. I can do this here on this place too. I make the two faces visible, and now I can move it back, and it takes some time and I see the face follows. This is possible in all areas, and we have a closed system here in this way, and so we can create our shoe model, and it's also a nice feature that I can use it for car design too. For example, if I put here on this face, I hide this information, I put here on this face cell, and I say the cell should range from 1 to 2 and 1 to 2. So I have this subface, and now I can create here a hole. Okay, and next thing, I hide the cell, I make here the reverse. So, and I have to hide the inner face. So, and I have here an opening for a light, and with some fantasy you can say you can create here a second opening for the second light, and you can install here a chair, and you have a car. The same, it's also possible to open here the surface for the drivings.